Alabama Brewers Guild, alabeer.org. A Belgian style double ale with mulberry.
All right, welcome back, everybody. Thanks again for joining us. Once again, if you guys can, check out our charity down below, American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. Music is still provided by Sirenscape, and all the background sounds. This is a great little program. I like it. And the maps are from Mike Schley, which is the actual cartographer for Wizard of the Coast. You can find that stuff online. And the images, of course, are from the official stuff from Wizard of the Coast as well, from the adventure Curse of Strahd. All legalities out of the way.
Strahd.
It's the name of the adventure.
Yeah, Curse of Strahd.
Spoilers.
Now that you know who he is, he's kind of a big deal around here.
Well, because he has his own little kingdom that he's, like, semi-quasi-forced.
And his place smells of rich mahogany and...
Many leather
bound books. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there it is. I lost it for a second. Thank you for finding it for me.
Don't worry, I'm here for you.
Sex Panther. Maybe that's what
the clone.
Maybe that's what your dad needs.
Oh my god.
No.
That's wrong.
He is the one
so
that made Sex Panther. He's the one that made it. Both of us having too much fun with this.
Alright.
Please didn't sleep with him.
Well, I could be a panther.
Let's go with those guys, huh?
Honestly, he might be into
it. So, you have the inn northeast of you. You're right now in the center square. You have a sobbing woman coming from a couple buildings south of you.
I think we're going to the sobbing woman.
Okay.
This is the teen unit.
I like it.
Teen unit? Okay. I'm going to just make some room. Yeah, that's okay. I'm sorry for the viewers, I don't have a map of Barovia up. So, anyway, they're in the town square and they're heading south to, that would be the little red building that there. Yes.
That?
Yes.
We heard ourselves like blocks away.
So, we found a moaning sob floats through the still, gray streets, coloring your thoughts with sadness. The sounds flow from a dark two-story townhouse. Now, Barovia itself is very run down. Looking at the houses, you can expect no new materials are coming in here. So, paint is peeling, everything's cracking. It's just drab, would probably be a word.
Yeah.
For it.
So the most colorful thing here is that little freaking scarf I'm wearing on my head.
Yes.
Yes. You will not stand out whatsoever.
You're one solid color.
Yeah.
Mine has multiple colors. No, but your bright red colors probably scare people.
So.
Wow.
Most things should just scare people.
True.
Especially when we found how young you are.
Yeah.
Looking at the windows, they also appear to be boarded up.
Oh. Well, I'll just figure out where to knock on the door. Does it have a door?
We shouldn't. This seems like it's
there's
haunted.
A door.
There's a
ooh, could
right
be
outside.
Haunted.
Probably haunted.
It's not real. Haunted house.
I don't know. Everything is weird. Yeah. Maybe it does, like...
Maybe there's like, I don't know,
a sad lady that needs help.
She's gonna be hot.
The way things are going around here, I don't think so, Red.
I mean, have you seen
you don't hear a response. You just hear a consistent sobbing.
Sobbing intensifies?
Let's go in.
Same level. You turn the door and it creaks over.
Ooh!
Is there any light inside?
There is no light inside. Barely light coming through, like the separated. There you go.
Goggles on.
Goggles engaged.
Oh, yeah, picturing you right now.
That should be like your code word for like starting a fight. should be our safe, like our not
catchphrase.
Starting a fight in the dark.
Safe word.
No, or like the opposite of a safe word, like
danger.
You know,
danger.
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 Yeah.
Danger. So we're like, we think conversation isn't going super well, but so we just have
your goggles on, guys.
Like goggles on, and that's how we know it's time to start.
So Shanna, what does it look like with the goggles on?
Everything's kind of has like a weird kind of glow.
Black
it's
and
like
white
I can.
Kinda.
No, it's in color.
Oh,
it's
cool.
Just everything's kind of. I can see in the darkness. Like it's not light. It's just everything. It's visible.
It's like infrared-ish.
No,
it's
like
kind of
dark
shades
vision.
Of gray.
It's just dark vision.
It's just very muted
like
color.
It's
like
just
it just enhances whatever particles of light are actually reflecting off of it. It just enhances a little bit.
50 shades of gray. Everything's about to get a little bit saucy up in here.
Oh. Well, do we see anything open in the door? Just kind of a.
Looking inside, you just see.
Can you see ghosts with your goggles?
No,
Mozo. Oh.
What is in the mist?
Old furniture.
I'm just like feeling really goofy today. Okay. I can't hold it back.
That's fine.
Let it come through. Let it just let me.
The sobbing and walking in, the sobbing appears to be coming from up the stairs.
Oh, okay.
Is there anything out of place? Do I see anything
like
out of
dead
place
bodies.
In this room?
Ooh. Broken furniture, like nobody really lives here?
No dead bodies, nothing like broken. The furniture itself is.
Any smells?
Sure. Just dusty, like walking into
gross.
Like a closet door that's been closed for like a week because we went on vacation. You open it up for the first time, it's just like musty. There it is, that's the word I was looking for. It's just.
Musty.
It's not
dank.
It's very dank. Not the good way.
But not like dead body dank?
Not dead body dank.
Okay.
Just
like mothball
thing.
Mothball,
yeah. What would you like to do?
Go
upstairs. Briar wants to go up the stairs?
Yeah, we're upstairs.
All right. Are we going to try and find this prime person?
Yeah, what is it?
Just,
can
just,
I do an arcana check for anything magical? That's not my role, but I'll take it.
Okay.
It's not an intentional roll.
It was an unintentional, but it's a 15, and I have 4 Arcana, so I'm going to roll with a 19 Arcana check.
You do not sense anything magical.
Good. Alright, guys, I don't think anything magical is really going on here, so let's just be on guard. Go check on this weepy woman.
Okay.
Or man, we don't know. Could be a weepy guy.
Do you want to pass
that
trace?
Do you? I think it would be fun.
Yeah.
Jingle, 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 jingle.
So no pass without trace, or with the pass without trace? Okay. So walking up the stairs, there are 2 bedrooms. The sobbing appears to be coming from the one with a partially open door.
Can we see anything through the crack in the door? Or is it like cracked where we can't see in through that crack? It's like we're standing in this hallway and the door's like this, so we can't.
You can walk up to the door and kind of peek your head through, but you don't see anything where the opening is giving you.
I want to listen to the closed door, see if I can hear anyone in there.
Okay.
Well, then
we're like,
yep.
Open the door!
I mean, what do perception?
Just
yep.
Excuse us. Hello?
Hello?
18?
You don't hear anything inside of the door. And you do not get a response.
Yo.
The sobbing continues.
Man, this girl is sad.
Sitting in the middle of the floor is a.
Which probably like a.
That appears
doll.
To be a woman, cross-legged, just clutching something close to her chest.
Are you okay?
Hello.
You can see her kind of crying, sobbing, rocking back and forth a little bit. And she does not respond.
Maybe should be fine.
To,
not okay.
Nope. Well, we've come this far. Maybe Brar should check on her.
Well, I don't know.
I don't think
I
she's going to be physically.
It kind of seems like she's having a moment.
Nope.
Look? Does it, I mean, is she cradling some, like, little baby?
Jenny's gone.
Is she
cradling
a creature, or is it, like, just an object?
Go ahead and make perception check.
I'm just, I gotta
ooh,
see
what's the advantage? Just like.
I rolled a 20 on my perception check. I mean, I rolled a 16, but I got a 20.
You hear her mumble, Gertruda. And then it appears that she's holding something almost small, maybe small baby slash childlike.
Oh,
but you can't really see because her back's to you.
This is even creepier. The hair dark.
Maybe we just we'll go ask Ismark about this. I'm sure if there's somebody crying about it, like that, maybe that would be.
Can I touch her shoulder and ask
her
if it's okay?
You're so scary.
Yeah.
Okay.
You sure you want to scare her on top of everything else? That
well, we've been making noise.
I mean she definitely heard us.
I mean, she had to have heard us.
You think?
Everybody,
you
can borrow my whistle if you want. Excuse me.
So you touch her shoulder and ask her if everything's okay. Peering over her shoulder, you see that she's holding a malformed doll.
Oh my god, yeah.
And she says, "My daughter is. She left.
Where did she go?
I don't know.
What happened?
I don't know. She was here and then she was gone.
When?
Just the other day. I fear for her.
So how
You've
old is she?
You've been just like sitting in this room and crying for like days. That doesn't seem very productive.
Also, what's with the weird doll?
This was her doll.
Well, no wonder she left. Why would he get her such a creepy thing?
Oh my
it's...
god. How old is your daughter?
So
how old is she?
She's a teenager.
Oh. You should definitely ask your dad about that.
He still plays with the doll. He probably knows her.
He probably knows.
So the doll itself has a strange leer and wears a sackcloth dress.
Can I arcana check that little fucker?
Yeah, sure.
Are we still talking about her dad?
Oh, and this is the woman right here.
Let me see her face.
She's just trapped, kind of dirty looking.
Sad.
Sad.
She have eyeballs?
She looks like a peasant.
No.
You can.
Yeah. God. You can
peasant.
Smell the poverty.
Her clothes are ragged.
Yeah, definitely smell poverty.
Oh my god.
They're dirty in places.
It's 13.
The worst.
You do not sense magic from it.
Do you sense sadness from it?
You sense a lot of sadness from it. You do see a little tag on it, though.
Ooh.
And a little tag, it says, "Is no fun, is no Blinsky." With a little exclamation point.
Is Mark.
Is no Blinsky?
Blinsky. Blinsky?
Fuck. So devil's town. Do you want me to just burn it to the ground? I feel like I can just burn this
down.
You feel like
we're
still better than Fandolin.
Yeah, this is like worse than Fandolin. This is dark Fandolin.
This was given. This was mine. This was my doll. I gave it to her.
No.
And then she was sobbing.
Ask where she got it.
Where did you get this doll from?
It was a gift.
From who?
Wait, if I said you got it.
Yes, it was given to me in my youth.
Oh,
am I your mother?
What's a Blinsky?
He's the toy maker here.
He's creepy.
I hate spice.
And did Blinsky make this doll?
Yes.
How old is Blinsky?
How much acid does he take?
Made this in his youth. And she almost kind of shrugs her leg like, it's not porn.
These are not, like, real questions to her right now. Her
daughter
is gone.
Where's Gertruda?
But, I don't know. She's peeing off our days, right? Have you asked anyone else in town, or have you just been here crying?
Have you looked for her?
Where would she go?
Does she have
a boyfriend?
You see, she's getting frustrated now with you guys.
Yeah,
does she have a boyfriend? Does she have friends? You know?
Come on.
Yeah, I'm going to console her.
Understand.
No, I'm sure. What kind of a monster do you think I am?
Alright, let's take it one piece at a time. Did she say anything to you before she left?
No.
The last time you saw her, What'd she say?
Just leave me.
That's what she said. Not very helpful, lady.
I want you to leave.
I want to help
you.
You
make me angry.
Okay.
It sounds like she was really upset with you.
Yeah, let's leave. Are there any, in this room, are there any pictures of the daughter?
No, there's no pictures or anything around. It's just a sobbing woman crying over her lost daughter, and you guys are harassing her. Hey, where the fuck did you get that doll?
You know what? Fine, let's leave her alone. This place is depressing anyway.
How old is he?
What
did you learn in
What's your name?
Mary.
Mary. Sorry to hear that your daughter left. Expect to be traveling around. If we run across her, we'll make sure to send her home or send you word or something like that.
And you can just see that she's still sobbing up for a second. She just pauses. Thank you.
Yep. Should we keep it down? Like, she's crying really low. Maybe not. Maybe just... Okay, well, I hope you, Mary, I hope you feel better. And if you need us, ask around. I don't know.
We're going to be trapped here anyway, so you might be able to find us.
Well, who knows?
Yell our names on the wind.
What's
Mary
your name?
Gertruda.
Well, this is, Motho.
Motho.
You don't give a creepy lady your name?
I'm Brar.
This is how gypsy curses get stuff.
That's Minkle. This is Red Jenny.
I'm Shanna, the great and powerful.
This is, Jim Jam.
Like crazy.
All right, well, Minkle. Minkle's on your back, hanging out.
Whatever he wants to do.
I'm sure.
I started writing Mary and it turned on the Minkle. Because I got distracted.
Mary. I don't have any, power to see things. So, sorry.
What are you looking to see?
Just seeing if I can see things.
I was just, can you definitely see,
the conundrum.
Like a bloodhound and see if you can smell the daughter?
Oh, because the doll probably smells like her daughter.
Or her bedding or whatever.
Is it on your little shapeshift list?
Let's see.
Bloodhound? Something cute.
Or like some other hunting dog or something.
Or like a panther, I don't know, whatever.
Oh yeah, I'm like
a
bear and
a panther. I have like some smells.
Is this...
whatever hunts people, just whatever.
A bear?
A giant ass.
Keen smell. Even as a black bear, I have a keen smell. Let's see. Blood hawk.
Just turn to a blood hawk and just walk and
badger,
fly.
Bat, and boar.
Fish
honey,
really
don't give a shit.
Hmm?
Fish have really good sense of smell.
Shark.
Sir. Yeah, but I feel like if
speak
I was like a black bear wandering around town with a keen smell,
and so I was like, bloodhound would be the first option, like a hunting dog of some variety.
I mean, yeah, hunting dog.
Also,
can...
Do we really know what's weird here? Because everything is weird here.
I could do dire wolf. Which has keen hearing smell.
Well, you'd be able to hear her cry really loudly. Speaking of which, let's get out of here. This is really creeping me out.
I mean, it's a good idea for later if we need it.
Yeah, well, if she's only been gone a few days, this might be the best opportunity we have of a sense of being here, if she ever existed.
Direwolves can move faster than a cat.
Well, let's direwolf.
Well, worst case scenario, you can always just, like, go be a wolf and then like sniff around and then like remember that smell if you smell anything and then you can always
like when I'm an elf if I remember a smell can I
don't know if you'd smell it again if you were an elf but if you were like, if you were a wolf again and you smelled it
so you smell as an animal and then retain it so that way if you do smell it again you can recognize it is that your question
yeah more or less
do you lose the memory of it when you turn into a wolf
I'd say it depends on how long it is you're going to roll for it.
You
can also...
My mouth is not getting us anywhere today, so I can just hang out as a wolf.
That's what she said.
Alright, I'm going to wolf out.
Okay.
Maybe out of the hallway.
Yeah, sure.
Just I'm gonna tell her.
She's
first.
Distracted.
Yeah. We'll just ask. Is the other room your daughter's room?
She's sitting inside her.
Oh, this
room.
Is her,
yeah.
Her room.
All right.
All right. So we're going to do something. Do not be alarmed. She's not a werewolf.
I'm just a regular wolf. She's just a druid. I'm not a wolf yet, so I can say that.
Okay.
I'm just going to smell around, and then hopefully I can catch a scent of your daughter at some point here.
Do you have anything of hers that was important to her that you haven't been smuggling for the past couple days?
Hmm.
Like her
bed.
As long as you haven't been sleeping in her bed like we
thought. There's clothing around. Not much, actually, because there's not this a lot of clothing around.
I guess you'll just use sticks.
There's really not much.
Hairbrush?
Can I gargle with him?
Just your mouth open until she's like, oh, he's sleeping with his mouth open?
Have you been sleeping in her bed?
No.
Okay, then I'm going to sleep in her bed. As
okay.
A wolf! As a wolf! So we can track her scent?
She's very disturbed
what?
By the wolf.
But no, no. Hey, focus. Mary, look at me. Two eyes. And can you describe your daughter to me?
Beautiful. She was beautiful.
Yeah, wolf hair. This is Bulgaria or...
But it will be.
That's the one.
Bulgaria.
It's new Bulgaria.
New Barovia. Okay, so you would say about... 4.5 feet.
She's a
human?
She's upwards 4, lower 5-ish.
She's a tall one.
Actually, well, due to the poverty, people probably are shorter in that situation. So yeah, you're probably 4.5, upper 4s.
So midget.
Oh, okay.
Dark hair?
Brown hair.
Brown hair.
Hair.
Wolf. Big, beautiful eyes.
I'm a wolf now.
What color? Brown?
Blue.
Blue eyes. Big blue eyes.
And brown hair?
Brown hair.
Is it a teenager?
Legs that go all... No, okay. And... distinguishing features?
Any moles or...
Ominous, like, wolf-shaped birthmarks?
Scars.
Yeah, bat-shaped birthmarks.
Beards.
Puncture wounds.
Maybe like a lightning bolt on her forehead?
No, nothing like that.
Oh. What?
She was safe here. Now she's not.
So she had flawless complexion.
Does she have any teeth?
Yes.
Does she have altered teeth?
Yes.
We are literally the worst people ever.
Brown hair, blue eyes.
Out of the ground as a wolf laughing inside.
I mean, you can kind of... take a look at Mad Mary's facial features, and then hopefully...
She apologized?
Well, I'm sniffing the bed.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Maybe?
I'm sniffing the bed.
Probably not.
It's, yeah, that's...
Probably
that,
not.
I wasn't trying to be mean.
Probably
Wait,
not.
Did you call her Mad Mary?
Because she's crazy.
Oh, well, yeah. So, like, this is not even real.
Ooh.
Well, she said it. She said she was.
There's
does
a way
the
to...
bed smell like another person?
You're in wolf form now?
Yes.
She kind of... shudders away from you, even though you told her.
That's why I'm distracted.
I'm
trying to distract you.
I'm sniffing.
Okay,
I'm
so
sniffing the bed. Does the bed even smell like another person?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's make a perception check.
Yeah.
To see how much you retain. Or.
You know.
Or nature.
You know
check,
it's a number.
Mm-hmm. So many smells. So mm-hmm.
I have keen smell, so that means. What does that mean? Advantage on perception checks.
Who?
So that's my wolf wisdom, right?
Yeah. No, it'll be your own. No.
Yeah, you keep your mental stats.
Yeah,
so
you keep
your characters
or bonuses. It should be up there, 4 or 5.
Where am I? 7. 15. What? Not 7?
This. No, you're right. Yeah, because you have your
wisdom is +4.
Yeah,
and
plus your
bonus.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. 15. No, thanks.
Yeah, 15.
Okay. So it smells like a separate human being.
Okay.
Like a recent human being?
Like a recently separate human being?
Not a dead, decaying human being. Alive.
Okay.
No, I mean, like, are we talking, like, a scent that's years old, or, like...
No, just either a day or two.
Okay, so the daughter potentially will.
All right, so I retain this, though?
When you recall it, we shall find out. Depends on how long it's been. I mean, I don't know if you can retain it for years.
I'm just saying, like...
Well, okay, how many brown-haired, blue-eyed people could there be?
Everyone
right.
in this town.
Everyone in town is brown and blue.
What's her name? We should. Oops, sorry, I'm
the people.
What you can
you
say?
Gertruda.
What's her name?
You have to say five syllables.
Hey, you're fifth level now.
Wait, I have to say all five.
Nah.
You just say bro with animal.
Bro.
What is exactly name? I don't know. her name
Gertruda.
Is Gertrude.
Oh yeah,
Gertruda.
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 Well, Mary, I think we have enough information to go on. Briar has like a little pad of paper out and he's just scribbling.
Are you writing the invoice, Briar?
Wait, did he have like a little like private eye hat and everything?
No, but I'll get one.
Mako and Jim had the same matching outfits.
Yeah.
Yep. We'll do our we'll keep her out for this Mary. And oh that's you, sorry. That's the one. Yeah, okay, thank you, Officer Red. And
now all of a sudden we're a noir.
And yeah.
Cheers.
I hope you have a lovely afternoon.
And find
some booze.
just crying. Thank you.
Sadness.
Let's go.
Booze.
And you guys leave down the crickety crickety stairs out the crickety crickety door.
Close the door.
Can I just make an insight check on all of that? Just see if she was just actually fucking crazy, or
yeah, sure.
It's a natural one. I fully believe she's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Fully believe she's crazy. Or
I fully believe she was telling the
yeah.
truth. Fucking
you don't know her not, but
she's not.
She's
yeah.
Meanwhile, I'm a wolf.
You know, pork. I don't think that doll had all of its stuffing.
Other game.
I mean, it was
so you're going to. So you guys are out on the streets.
Yeah.
Do I smell her anywhere?
So we're just like watching the wolf.
Roll a new with advantage perception check.
So that was
14. Oh, same thing twice.
Mm-hmm.
No, 6 and 7, but. The advantage.
Yes, you kind of get her scent.
Toward the
house. Heading out the town westward.
Out of the town westward. We're going west later, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I just like straight up dog point. Yeah. I lift that one paw.
Good, Musa, good.
If we had any snacks. Give them to you. But we don't. I will get you a bottle of wine at the inn.
You hear a townsperson shout, "Wolf! Wolf!"
Uh-oh. Oh shit. Sorry, guys.
They're here! Right. And then you hear like a door slam.
Maybe I should have picked a different animal.
That's why I suggested the panda. Or the
little
puppers. Yeah. Did you say panda?
Panther. Panda.
Definitely
panda.
Definitely
panda.
Should I be wolf?
Yeah.
Or can you more, like, shapeshift from another form into just a dog? You'd be like, no, everybody, look, it's just...
Yeah, can you just turn it into,
like a really
dog.
Cute golden retriever?
And that would count as their second shift, though.
Yeah, but can you become a dog? Basically, so what we're asking. And she's like, "Oh, it must have been the mist or something." Yeah, and buddy, this is just.
So Panther's not gonna be any less scary.
Well,
she's
you know what, Motho,
I
think you be you, Motho. You stay exactly who you are, and then we'll sort it out.
Okay, you killer whale.
I could be a jackal. I don't know if that'd be any better.
So, you have to have seen the animal.
Hmm. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I think dog might be easier. There's gotta be a thing.
Yeah, if she's seen dogs before,
ape,
yeah.
Badger, bat, black bear,
badger,
camel,
badger.
Cat, constrictor snake, deer, eagle.
There's not a dog in there?
Well, I mean, you can assume dog and
it's called
yeah.
dog and use like the wolf form.
Yeah, that's fine.
So I'm a dog now?
Well, the question is, do you want to use another use of your...
Yeah, I don't think you're going to be battling anything, I hope.
Okay, you shift down into a less scary-looking wolf.
I'm a dog.
Yeah.
Okay,
the wolf's form into a dog.
You have a weenie.
Or you could just be husky. So they're because then it's a legitimate, like, oh, hey, no, confusion. This is just a dog.
What are huskies called?
I just fucked everything up, didn't I?
No,
we're going to get shot
their
at.
Specific huskies have their own specific...
They're
dogs.
He chose wolf.
I'm just comfortable with wolf.
It's not good
on bear.
They have their own little word.
There's. Remember, there are werewolves here, and there are wolves in the forest. These people have been preyed upon. Probably by these nasty things.
Okay, I'm a dog now, anyway.
Okay.
What kind of dog?
A bloodhound.
Give me a corgi.
Corgi.
Oh my god,
he's not gonna be a corgi.
That's reasonable. I wouldn't be stuck in a corgi body either.
Come on. He was amazing. He was a corgi.
Who?
Alright, well, I probably just got y'all in a lot of trouble, so.
Right. I've lied.
So I will go with some sort of hunting dog. What's like a hunting dog?
Weimaraner.
Basset
Hound. Ooh, I like that.
It's
like
one
his dog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fast,
great. You had the same dumb.
They do look really dumb.
So, yeah. So our one friend back home has same dog breed, and it's just like you just look at like, the dog's face, and the dog's just like.
My family always has Weimaraners.
It's just like, man, is there anything up there? You're just not sure.
She runs forever.
She doesn't know any better. That's why.
Well, I mean, assuming that we don't get lynched by these town folks, shall we go talk to Ismark?
Maybe we could just stop at the inn because we will just say we're looking for this girl and go from there.
Well, perfect. That's where Ismark is. Yep. That's where
Mark is.
Yeah. Is the inn.
Ismark is.
There's probably more,
the
more than one Ismark there, too.
I didn't know I could turn into just
Are you Ismark? Isn't Mark. Alright. There's no town guard response or anything to those calls. You hear some people kind of take shuffling off, running away. But you guys
like
do...
Both of, can you bark really cute?
Head
yeah.
up.
Insert
to the
cute bark.
Bork.
Make it into the inn then? With
mm-hmm.
Motho,
if they
dog form.
Let us in with a dog,
it smells girl.
Is
it
like one of those lame inns, or is it a dog friendly inn?
Only one way to find out.
Can we go in there and we ask politely, do you allow dogs in on your premises?
You're also bringing Minkle in.
Does it have a door, or does it have like saloon doors? It's very important.
Oh my god.
Definitely saloon doors. And instead of, like, spears rustling when you walk in like a cowboy, it's your bells.
Yep.
okay.
All right,
do
so
I smell a girl in this place?
You do not. Approaching the inn, or the tavern, there is a single shaft of light that thrusts
shaft.
Illumination into the main square. That is writing this for us, I swear to God. Read it as is.
Oh, come on. You can't use words like shaft and thrust in the same sentence.
Shaft of light thrusts its way into the square.
You can't.
Come on, wizards. Come on, man. Seriously.
You just don't do that.
It fills you with a warm feeling.
Just feel it expanding inside of you.
Oh, God.
Into the main square. Its brightness looking like a solid pillar in the heavy fog.
It's a phallic reference, guys!
So, wait.
We are on the phallic road, so...
Above the gaping doorway.
I'm done. You got it that last one.
No, I'm serious!
It's like
I was going to say the back doorway or something. So,
don't tell me there's like a plush carpet at the door too. Leading it.
A sign hangs precariously.
Promiscuously.
Askew. Proclaiming this to be the blood.
On the vine
tavern.
No, that was intentional.
All of that was intentional.
That was written from the book. And actually, if you perception check as you walk through as a dog, and if you actually, you can't even see it, it's too high up for you.
14.
Dogs can't see that high up.
They can't look up. 20.
Okay, you notice that.
Wait, is it writing? I can't do that.
No, that's true, you can't write.
I point out the writing, someone can read.
Oh, okay. I have a 16, so.
Okay. Go around the tail. You can't. Because you're a dog. Can't look up. You can't, because you can't read.
Totally look up.
But it's very difficult to see, like, that height, that angle.
Fine.
But dogs can't walk backwards downstairs. Or is that? Okay.
There's a sign.
What does it say?
The closest specialist sign reveals that it originally read Blood of the Vine, but the N, an N has been scratched over with the F.
Alright.
Used to be Blood of the Vine, now it's Blood on the Vine. A little.
It's all gross. I hate this town.
This is like Fandolin 2.0.
I still like it more than Fandolin. You know, do you know why? Especially because there's no Fandolins.
So we're just walking in the sex
central. Walking in, there is a blazing fire. Scant warmth to the few that are huddled within. There's a barkeep.
You just use a body. It's just changing from dog farm to.
I don't like this switch. This is better.
It's cold. I don't want to wear it.
It's true. Yeah. Oh. So the climate itself is like, I guess November rain.
You know, it's like perpetually Seattle.
But cold, yeah, like fall slash winter
ish.
Alright, well, can you put a blanket on you or something?
You want like a dog sweater?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm sure Shanna has one.
There's the barkeep.
I do.
There is three Vistani sitting together, and there appears to be a man sitting alone.
Who that man?
Would that man be? He fine? Just go up there and sniff him.
I'm gonna go up to the barkeep.
Everybody likes dogs, so I'm gonna go to that man and I'm gonna sniff him.
No. Stay with us, nothing.
Stay focused.
Let go. Maybe he smells
like that.
Maybe. Smell like that. Yeah, we're gonna
smell everything.
Then they're all gonna
wrap
and sniff him.
I'm gonna sniff everything.
Okay, Red. You're gonna have to hit on that guy.
Ooh. Hello. Why is it him? Is he Vistani?
He is not Vistani. Vistani are very, that is the man you're sniffing. Vistani are very prominent with bright colors, gold jewelry.
Jesus Christ.
He's giving scratches on the butt.
Yeah.
Lower. Yeah. I'm being serious. I'm sniffing him. What does he smell like?
He smells like a human male.
Has he bathed recently?
Sure.
Look at that hair. It's not. It's recently washed hair.
He pets you. Nice. And he sees the rest of the group walk in and instantly recognizes that you guys are not from here.
What
game
is this? He waves you over.
Okay, I'm just making eyes at us because I'm going to go talk to this one.
You can go turn to the barkeep if you want.
Well, no, I mean, if he's like,
Yeah, he's like.
Making eyes at you?
Not like those kind of eyes. I like better eyes.
Every time.
I like his hands. Where's
his taste? He has giant teeth. How does he taste like? I don't know, lick your own hand and then tell me what it tastes like. I don't know.
So it doesn't taste like anything.
Can you make an insight check before you lick his hand? Just to make it, or after you lick his hand?
Probably not. So, right, so we are walking over to this gentleman.
Eight.
Yes.
Alright, so we'll walk over there.
Seems genuine with the petting.
I see that you are petting our hand, our hound, Motho.
That's a strange name for a dog.
Short for Morning Thunder.
We have left alone hand heel.
One for a normal name for a dog.
It's exactly. Thank you. So, what are you doing here?
He wouldn't by any chance be named Ismark.
Oh, no.
Is he?
Who's asking?
Umbra.
Bar from where?
Bramble Crag.
I know this Bramble Crag. But you're not from here, you're not working with Strahd.
I haven't met Strahd.
We don't know this Strahd fellow.
We did meet a guy named Mr. Jenny.
Aldrich.
Vesuvius.
Serenus.
Serenus.
And who is he?
He's a Vestani. Really good looking, loves to screw women. Sometimes men, maybe. Anything that moves.
Look, Ismark. You're Ismark, right?
Yes.
We came through here hunting wolves. We were told to take a potion.
Oh. Yeah, we get some of you in here every once in a while.
Potions?
Adventurers.
It's personal for us. We're not just adventurers. We're here.
I thought you meant other bars, and I was really confused.
You all want to like.
Yeah. You could have been other dwarves.
But I think he meant adventurers. Maybe that's what he said.
Tell us about this Strahd fellow. We've not heard anything about him.
He is the devil.
Well, that's actually one of the few things we have heard about.
Now, do we mean literal devil or just like really terrible person?
Yeah, is it just a title you have to call him? Like Count or whatever?
I would have gone with
Marquis or something.
That's a bunch of fancier time. I like high chief person.
He is all that is evil.
Okay.
That's what else? Look, we've seen some shit, Papa D. We've been to Phandalin. We have seen evil. Well, you two just assign him this kind of title.
Phandalin. I've never heard of Phandalin.
Well, honestly, it's worse than that.
Yeah, it's...
Then I do not want to go there, ever.
Nobody ever wants to go there, so...
No one wants to live in
Phandalin.
It's terrible.
You think this place is
crap?
Wait till you get
to Phandalin. Well, it actually has a much brighter colors in here, but they're kind of a clever ruse.
Mm.
And they do, and then it's just awful.
At least you know what kind of shithole we have here, huh?
Right. So...
What is going on here?
Here? Me?
And everything. Give us your story. We'll buy everybody around or something. You guys do take regular coin, right?
Why is she the party banker?
She knows how to run a business and she's only 19 years old.
Checks out. Let's do that.
Check that. Make it a break.
All the clothes.
Like, we actually go to do a withdrawal.
Fine, red silk clothing.
Yep.
Best Vistani way.
That's
the Vistani way.
Colorful.
True to her heritage.
You said there's a group of other group of people at the bar?
What the fuck?
No, this is not the dog.
Okay.
It's your natural talking dog.
No.
Yes, there's the barkeep, and then there are three Vistani sitting at a table as well.
Okay. I'm going to go sniff them and say hi to them as a dog, too.
Okay.
I don't know if I have to roll anything.
Dog check.
Yes. You walk over.
Do you have to use deception to pretend to be an authentic dog?
I'm an authentic dog.
You want to be an authentic dog. I'll say either nature or deception, whichever one is higher for you. How much dog are you?
I just want to go sniff him.
All right, you walk over there and sniff him. And they kind of shoo you away.
They don't pet me?
Eh.
How rude!
Dicks.
Are you going to say how rude to
them? No.
You take care of the dog over here, huh?
That's a child.
Hey, sorry.
Hey.
Okay, there are some leash laws here, alright?
She likes people.
You tell me, you put me to the sign that says leash law, and then we will get her leashed. Until then, she is just sniffing you. You lay off the dog.
This is our tavern.
This is your tavern.
We would like to see your ownership of the tavern. Do you have a deed?
Who the hell are you?
We're just travelers.
I just like
with a dog that likes people.
And go back to the handsome men.
Okay. Rude. I'm gonna turn away from him.
These people are not related to them. They are assholes. I would not buy them a drink.
No.
But everyone else.
So do I smell anything on them of interest?
Wine.
Mm-hmm.
They do not serve dogs on wine, sorry.
Oh,
this is the kind of place that has like the cat wine and the dog wine, so you don't drink alone?
That's so much less depressing. So I can drink and not feel lonely. Perfect.
Listen.
So, Ismark himself, he's dressed somewhat better than Mary was.
Mary
more well kept. Combs his hair.
Is crazy.
Cleans himself. Nice fresh shave.
He is the son of the.
Where were we?
Ismark.
Yes.
We're kind of on our way to talk to Madame Evo. We're here from hunting.
Okay.
Hunting werewolves.
Yep.
Then you're in the right place.
But that's what I hear. But this dude, Mr. Ceramics.
Yes.
Counts up.
Navastani.
No, the new dad, Mr. Ceramics.
Oh.
Yeah, just go with it.
Yeah.
He said that we should talk to you first. Since you were kind of like on the way to. Why would he say a thing like that?
To talk to me?
Yeah.
Like, we have specifically named you. No one else in town, just you.
Yes, he said you could help us.
None of the isn't marks.
It's pretty well known. I do not like this Count Strahd.
And he hasn't killed you yet?
He's more diabolical than that. He tortures me.
How?
That being
he preys on my sister.
Which
Who's
one's
your
that?
Sister?
She got it right. Irina.
Is she here? Or?
No, she's not here.
Just Irina, or is Irina?
What a damn.
Her name. Irina.
How does he torture you through her?
Well, I suspect
he
takes the children away. He takes the
parents
away.
Oh, Irina is a grown woman.
What?
But he craves her as a spouse.
What? What? Wouldn't being married to the count of this place be a good spouse arrangement?
You know nothing of this man.
Well,
if he's even a man. I don't really know anymore.
He might be an elf, right? He's 400 years old.
He's... When he looks at her, it's with hunger.
Like
that of wolf?
Sexually?
And he has snuck in to her window.
I mean,
and
modern
fed
culture
her.
Says that is kind of okay.
Fed on her how?
Like,
there's bite marks on her neck.
Oh, Lord.
He's a vampire.
Twice now. I fear that one more and I'll lose her forever.
Aww. Has she been acting strangely?
No, yeah, it's just she can't remember.
He would bow on the window so nobody can come in. That's what you do with bad times in town.
We don't have that
metal
for her.
You make good.
Anyway, she's not safe here. I could use your help.
What would you like us to do?
There's another town. just along the road, northwest of here, Valaki. It has borders, it has walls, it has a guard force. If we were to bring her there, she'd be safe.
If he's capable of just sneaking into her window at night, why do you think she would be safe there?
There are no walls here. He can walk in, pass freely. At least there, there'd be guards and patrols.
Do you have any family there that she can stay with, or just...
Our only family, our father, just passed away the other day.
Oh, we're sorry for your loss.
Thank you. We aim to bury him.
Of natural causes? Oh.
Or vampire. No.
We...
Do you actually know what vampires are?
I want to roll something for if I know what he might be, given what he's told me so far.
Sure.
When he says count,
or he's just into some
said,
really weird shit.
I was saying cannibal.
Would that
Brad,
be?
Brad just doesn't know.
I've read
that
some of the books
would
that
be
some of the
history
had, and they will not.
That's
fine.
That's probably your strongest one, right?
Yeah, it's a 13.
Some of the ladies of the Blushing Blossom thought that many
not quite yet.
And watching them sleep was quite a phenomenon.
So wait, what's
men climbing into their windows and watching them sleep?
Yeah, I mean, you were
turn
on bitches.
But what about the bit where they bit them?
Well, you know, everybody has fetishes. They have to pay for them.
Yeah.
Don't
run
the brothel by turning people away with
weird
fetishes.
My father died.
Yeah.
I think he finally gave up fighting. I think his heart broke.
Aww.
Our mansion was under siege every night. Beasts clawing at the doors, at the windows.
Werewolves?
We do not know. We do not peek out to find out. And I think finally his heart gave out.
What?
Come on, we could try and comfort him.
I don't know. I don't really want to touch anything here.
Oh my god. Mage
hand it.
Well, he'll never know the difference. Just keep him distracted. It's just when you go to the other room is when they get suspicious.
Yeah, my wicked's completely depressed now, being in this general area.
So, what's our next step, do you guys think? We're going to try to
get this
out
of here, I guess? Because we're heading that way.
Escort her to Valaki?
I guess.
Is that towards... Which way is Valaki?
Is it further west
of you? It's just south of Lake Zarevich.
The fuck is where?
What, Lake Zarevich?
Lake Zarevich is northern point.
So
just
it is west of here.
Beneath Mount Baratok.
So it's northwest
yeah.
of here.
Northwest.
Northwest, yeah.
Okay. Do you know where Mount Baratok
is?
Is
this weird place
west-ish.
On the map?
No. It's like way off of here. Like, this is probably a cemetery that looks like.
It's gated cemetery.
She might be safe here.
Maybe just directly in her crypt.
Yeah.
Yeah, did you guys want to agree to do that?
I suppose. Although, I don't know if I want to be traveling with someone this count technically wants to go after.
It'd be a great way for us to talk to them.
Or it'd be a good way to get out of his favor. Very quickly.
We could actually do it. We want this girl. We want 4 free passes. Sorry, I'm going to go 5 free passes out of the Chanel.
He waves the barkeep to bring over a bottle of wine.
And the dog start whimpering.
And
we get you a
barkeep dressed in just plain clothes.
One of those undercover barkeeps.
Just walks over, just places down the bottle, collects a coin, turns around, walks back to the bar, continues cleaning the glasses.
Yeah, Is it like mechanical or like
is he a zombie?
Which is very, very particular about his emotions.
Is he human?
Would you like to roll?
Yes.
An investigation.
Do you smell like death?
You do not smell death.
Okay, 19.
Cool. 19. Yep. He's not mechanical. He's not dead. He seems like a human.
Seems.
Something seems off-putting, though.
Something seems what? Off-putting?
Off-putting by his actions. Just as you guys are now questioning it in real time, your characters are probably like, something...
You just seem to, like, not care or not like...
Is this a vessel?
I'm not
trying to get any sort of
feedback
from newcomers.
Roll a 15
for
Arcana.
This is
good. You
do
not sense any magic.
No.
This is just strange. It's not very good, but
it's not good. Yeah. Can't roll a check for anything, so he's not on the board.
Okay, so you want us to take your sister.
Yes, and we'll go. She can fend first. She can help fight. I can help fight.
Oh, you're coming with us.
Oh, yes. I would not leave my sister's side.
And we're going to go to Valiki?
Yes.
Valiki?
Valiki. Yes, Kukuliki. Yes.
I mean, I guess just to be helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Good to make some friends here.
So, yeah. What's up with this bad keep?
Oh, yeah, I swear, some people are here. They have no joy in life.
Yeah?
Most don't.
Well, have you tried a fresh color of paint or something? Really spruce this place up.
I don't think it's the place. It's the people.
Well, we would like to know about this land. We heard that Stroud came here several hundreds of years ago and may have potentially wiped out the original inhabitants.
And that is his own.
No, most of what I know is what's going on now. And that I would do everything in my power to dethrone him and cleanse his place of his curse.
I guess, is there anything else worth seeing in this town? Like, is it just hopping through?
Well,
nope.
There's a mercantile across the road.
Well, how late is it in today?
It's about mid-afternoon.
Mid-afternoon. How far is the next town?
Is
the next town Valiki, or is there...
So...
I'm just wondering, so if we're gonna set out, I want to make sure we don't get caught out.
Yeah, this way it was, you know...
Well, you know, I like sleeping under the stars, but I haven't seen any of this since we've been here.
No, we'll house you guys for the night. And then, in the morning, sorry with you, we'll bury my father and then we'll leave.
So do you think we should watch your sister overnight?
Yes, I'll introduce you to her when we leave here. I figured a round of wine can't hurt any of my spirits a little bit.
No.
What complaints here?
Do we want to drink the wine here? Everybody seems pretty proud.
I mean, the wine might be really good.
The wine is amazing.
It's
it is.
Do you want us to get you a little bowl?
Some people, it's the only thing that keeps them going, honestly.
Barkeep.
I hear you brought
I the reason why I braids and I ring a bell. A bowl, please.
A bowl.
One bowl.
Kind of looks around.
Actually, how many cups were there? Did he bring
us? I'm looking like this.
Enough cups for us all?
There are enough for the humanoids there.
Perfect,
oh.
Perfect. I put the cup for you down, and then I get my dwarven electrum drinking tankard.
Okay.
And I drink my wine out of that. So you have a wine glass.
So you don't ask for the bowl then? Okay.
Well, I mean, it seems like this would be funnier.
Fair enough.
Put both of your paws on either side.
I did
the barkeep that. Continues cleaning the glasses.
He doesn't even know that, like, they don't even care. There's a dog drinking wine here and they don't even care.
High-class dog, what do you want? It's a wine writer, of course it's drinking
it's
wine.
It's a wine writer. I get it. Any cheers? A little cheers, everybody. How far will you go? Will you help me take down Strahd if I need it?
Well, we just got here, right? Okay, so here's the deal.
Sorry, I know this can be overwhelming, but we've been living this in our entire life.
So, I mean, not to speak for, but we came here trying to hunt some werewolves, right? And now we're here and we hear, oh, you can't leave when Strahd says you leave. And I won't lie, like, this place better than Phandalin.
Definitely.
But I still have the feeling I might want to leave at some point.
Yeah.
So riddle me this, Ismart. Mark. Whatever. let's say we do all this stuff and make an enemy out of this devil, Strahd. How the hell do we get home?
Do you have a way for us to leave this misted
planet? We kill Strahd. That's the only way.
Oh, my dad does.
I'm not going to say it's going to be easy.
Well, we'll help you with your sister, but let's collect a little more information with Strahd before
we
go head to head.
We don't want the staff any trouble here. We're just passing through. We are after a specific goal, maybe finding our dog's parents. And, yeah.
Well.
I mean, I wanted to gauge whether he's telling the truth. I'm just,
sure, yeah,
say,
that's that, yeah.
It's not really one of my... It's a 7.
Seems to be honest. Seems to be concerned about his sister. Whenever he speaks Strahd's name, you can see him get angry and kind of grit his teeth a little bit.
Does this guy have like a bounty on him or something?
Who, Strahd?
Strahd.
Usually it's
I tell you what, you kill Strahd, you can take anything inside of his castle.
Nice.
Have you seen his castle?
Well, you are. We literally just got here.
Is
come inside.
Wait,
what
is
there
something I want to like get all up with in that? Because he's not a castle. Can't. It's just like...
I'm telling you, Bart.
He motions you guys come outside real quick.
Okay.
Right.
Let's go
outside.
Jenny
and Barovia.
And volunteers tribute.
God.
So walking outside of the tavern, you see to the northwest a steep cliff a couple hundred feet up. And through the clouds, you can just make out this appears to be a large castle.
All right.
Could be a lot of treasure there.
Could be a lot of treasure there. It's also a fantastic castle. It could probably need some better decorating. More pep for the peasants.
Yeah. It could have tapestries.
He cares not for us. We're merely playthings.
And you say, okay, whatever. My brain hurts.
Poor bro.
But we shall rejoice. I found you. You find me.
Yeah, my dad told us to find you.
Either way, perhaps this is fate. Perhaps now's the time we take him down. Maybe not now. But I'll convince you. You'll see. I don't need to convince you. You'll see how evil this Strahd is.
Well, we'll say about keeping your sister safe.
Mm-hmm.
And let's just go from there.
We'll cross our bridge when
we
get there.
Flat daily fee.
Flat daily fee, 2 gold per person.
And 1 gold.
There's not much gold in Barovia.
Just joking.
pretty good.
We have jokes.
What's that?
So
when he paid, he actually saw the coin that he paid, and it was a
Stroud's bucks.
It was a coin with Strahd's face on it.
What kind of coin?
I mean, our coins are made out of precious metals. I feel like
they'd
be more valuable than they were in our world.
We haven't seen Strahd. It's slicked back black hair.
He looks like
it's a profile view of him now. Slicked back, long black hair.
Pulp Fiction.
Oh, yes.
John Travolta.
What's that?
John Travolta.
This is real hair, though.
Oh.
John Travolta, I'm sorry if you're watching this. I apologize. Love me.
If he's watching this, thank you.
Donate below. Thank you. Just level two, and we're good. We're square. I love your movie.
Seriously, most excellent work.
All right.
So trash bucks. So what did we do with?
Straw dollars.
Oh my god,
okay, whatever.
Straw
dollars.
What's up with silver pieces?
They're strawlers.
Straw dollars.
It can be like Canadian money or straws and strings.
Oh my god. Let's make that a thing. Let's make that a thing.
Spennies. Or strennies, I guess. I don't know what we're. The copper pieces here.
I just want him to like see you and be like, I need to have you.
I doubt it.
Well, that'll happen though.
He's
so cute.
Ew.
Who is this guy or Strahd?
He probably is.
Strahd?
That's Strahd.
He's got the same haircut as Trump's sons.
He is loaded, and he has some.
He casts a grease spell every day.
Better hairline though.
And on the flip side, the law can't find me in here.
I'm not really one to
so,
talk.
You can turn wherever you want. I'm a fun sheep.
I'm gonna show you how this works here.
You guys are really setting me on this whole right.
Trace get a little strawberry.
All right, girls, we'll go to work.
Let me give you a bunch of socks rolled up and just pack them in there.
All right, I've got a plan. Switch places.
Wait, are you trying to seduce Strahd or
Rudy Mark? Yeah, Strahd. He's loaded.
I think we're drunk at this point, and we're just like...
That was his real plan, because you guys wasted and just swap you out for a sister.
We won't know until we go to sleep in her bedroom, and he, like, puts her in the basement, and just one of us disappears.
Next week.
Not if I'm a dog.
It's just a dog.
And we have, like, a really dramatic playing of, like, where's Jenny? And she's like, I don't know where I am. We gotta find her. Turn into a dog. I don't have any more transformations left, guys.
Yeah,
okay,
but really, I just like
sorry, right, guys. I got it.
Bring it back in.
Wolf.
Okay, let's bring it back in, guys.
Okay,
get
yeah,
focus.
Okay, so we're
sorry.
Drinking with him. Our like, what time of day is it right now?
Early afternoon.
Yeah, by 2 or 3-ish.
Okay. I mean, is there anything to do here until it's time to turn in?
I got
why don't we head back to the mansion?
We can talk with your sister.
Right.
Maybe get some more information out of her.
And formulate a plan.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, let's head to the mansion. Wait, we just go with this guy? We just toss him, we're going back to his mansion?
Yeah.
We're going together.
He's got a mansion.
Yeah,
it's not a castle.
Should I, you know?
It's true.
I feel like you should run around a corner and then turn into an elf.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden you have an elf with you, too.
Yeah.
Why do we do that when we get back?
It'll be a fun prank.
Gotcha.
If we get back to the house, it'll just freak him out.
Wow.
Surprise.
Also,
a little bit of poop.
Right. Oh, the dog wants to sleep with me tonight? That's fine. What the fuck?
Before he's up next to a gorgeous half moon elf.
Sorry, I don't think you're disappointed.
You're full-blooded.
Okay, full-blooded moon elf.
Yeah, I'm full.
I think you should stay and milk the dog for him as long as possible.
Milk the dog.
Jesus.
Jesus, wet.
Crazy.
Jesus, wet.
I mean, you know, it's a shaft of light.
Pulsating.
I say pulsating. I think it is.
And the gaping entrance.
thrusting. was thrusts.
Oh, thrusting. Oh, sorry. Yes.
Thrusting shaft was the first one that just killed it. Killed the rest of it.
And that was all word for word.
Okay, so give us the description for the mansion. I'm ready to hear it.
Yeah. Let's just right. do it. We're gonna go to.
So you guys, chug the rest of your wine. Bring the glasses back in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Heading down south now, down the road.
There's
a dead end to the mansion itself. Is it
the
get cut off?
Oh, sorry.
There you go.
Well,
yep.
This is the mansion right here.
Yep. This is the Burgomaster's mansion.
Burgomaster's.
Wait a minute. If your father was the Burgomaster, are you now the Burgomaster, or is there some sort of election process?
Do you have to go through a culinary school?
Put up just buns and
no. I am the Sue Burgomaster.
Are those buns of steel or are you just a
as he walks every time is this toned ass.
He doesn't have a toned
gluteus max.
You're like an eye level with it too.
Oh my god.
Oh man, this is
well,
such here.
Giggliest session ever.
Seriously, the most depressing session possible. Becomes the most giggly session. I'm not sure if that's on purpose. Well, the day. We're all feeling good. Hey.
Thank you, alcohol.
Weary looking mansion squats behind a rusting iron fence.
Bring it in.
The iron gates are twisted and torn. The right gate lies cast aside, while the left swings lazily in the wind. The stuttering squeal and clang of the gate repeats with mindless precision. Weeds choke the grounds and press with menace upon the house itself, yet against the walls the growth has been tramped down to create a path all about the domain. Heavy claw markings have stripped the once beautiful finish off the walls. Great black marks tell of the fires that have assailed the mansion. Not a pane nor a shard of glass stands in any window. In fact, all the windows are barred with planks, each one marked with stains of evil omen.
So, alright, not a bad reading. Much better
mm-hmm.
than the previous place we visited.
Yes.
Thank you, Wizards of the Coast.
Way to keep
the first one was bring your teenage son to work day, I think.
Yes, it was.
Or daughter. Apparently,
or daughter. Probably daughter.
Because it's just as dirty. If not, possibly dirtier.
No, it was the guy who wrote it hadn't had any in a couple weeks.
So you're telling me you haven't seen what's done any of this?
We know it's Strahd's beasts. The werewolves, possibly wolves, the undead. It's.
Did you say, is that some kind of marking that I saw on those boards? Like you said,
the stains of evil omen. So that just translates to just
blood stains,
burn marks, claw marks, just.
Okay. I wasn't
things
sure
trying to break. Yeah, but then it's like someone's written on there.
Yeah, it was like runes or something for.
Yeah, omen command, yeah, exactly. Yeah. But after my father died, the attempted. They would not a dirty word for you guys.
Just unleash it on us.
That's what I was looking at, and that's when I avoided it. Attempted penetration of the mansion ceased. Like I said, Strahd is a maniacal person or thing, even. I'm not sure if he even enjoys it or why he does it.
Where is your sister right now?
She's inside.
Let's go and let's meet her.
Alright. Let's check the time. So, walking in, you notice that the interiors of the mansion are well furnished, but the fixtures show signs of great wear. Noticeable oddities are the boarded up windows, and the presence of holy symbols in every room. He points off to the side. There's a drawing room. On the floor is the burgomaster. He's lying in a simple wooden coffin surrounded by wilting flowers and a saint, or faint odor of decay.
How long has he been dead?
I don't know how. 3 days.
Have you gotten rid of his corpse yet? I've got an easy solution for that.
Fire?
Fire.
We...
The dead don't rise if you set them on fire.
We'd like to bury him in our family burial grounds behind the church.
Don't want to set him on fire.
It's okay. Set something else on fire.
This is right. To lay with our ancestors.
What did you do with his ashes?
But we've asked the townsfolk and no one's brave enough to stand with us out there.
Brave enough? We didn't stand with you. It's just a funeral.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's not like we haven't fought werewolves before or whatever.
Yeah.
And tomorrow we'll bury my father and we'll take my sister to Valkyrie. Oh, speaking of her.
If there's any moving dead bodies, I will be setting them on fire. I'm just letting you know in advance.
Yes.
If this corpse moves, you are not going to be liable for any corpses on fire.
I assure you, my father is as dead as dead can get.
But if he
we'll
moves,
see that he stays that way.
Yeah,
permanently. Just saying. From what we've seen.
If he moves, please.
Fool me once.
Put him back down here.
And even then, fire doesn't always kill him.
Yeah.
Wait, did I miss what attacks the house at night?
Strahd's beasts. They don't know because they haven't been outside. Like,
sure.
they hide.
They
but,
don't go upstairs.
But he said werewolves, wolves, and undead, presumably.
Yeah.
I don't think they've gotten in. So I don't think they've had to deal with them inside.
I
won't
have another transition, so. Hope they don't.
You're
going
to turn back into
tomorrow,
an
elf.
You're going to turn back into an elf, or you just submit to the skeleton for as long as possible.
How can. Can I fight as a dog?
Yeah.
All right. Stopper.
Sure.
Our dog is very fighty and when he wants to be.
I was gonna ask. Oh, right. So you want to bury this guy in the morning?
Yes.
Should we like dig a trench or something tonight, or like? Because my whole thought. Well, here's my thought. Right.
It's called the clay.
What?
The clay.
Yeah, that's what I said. It's what, like a couple hours to this other place, Valiki?
Valiki, about 8 hours.
Right? So we probably want to get, you know, not dawdle too long. If we're out there, like, digging trenches and stuff like that, sorry, graves.
That's the web.
And doing things. I mean, is there some of that? Can we kind of prepare tonight?
Sorry. I need to correct that. That is 17 hours.
Oh, Jesus.
Well,
we're going to stop in the den, it was fast. And then we don't have to go the
way. I think I know where those Vistani are. They're just they should camp by Zer Pool. T-S-E-R. Zer.
Zer Pool.
God damn it.
Deepool?
Zer Pool. Fuck Wizards of the Coast. I mean, not really. This is great.
Is it our pool? Is it their pool?
It's their pool.
What's the problem?
Is everyone's pool?
Yes.
Ismark.
Ismark.
Good to know.
It's when you're drunk at a bar and you're like, Ismark? And it's like, no, Ismark? Yes.
Ismark?
Right. Okay. So,
yes.
All I'm saying is, should we be digging, like, I'm gonna go dig a fucking hole tonight? Like, what, is there some sort of prep that we can do?
Or is there somebody in charge?
Do you have a place where we're going to, are we going back to that cemetery there?
Yeah.
Is that where your dad's going to be buried?
Yeah, on the northern part of town, there's a church and there's a cemetery behind it.
Okay.
Yeah,
we can head that way. Let me just grab my sister first. And head into the back of the mansion, you see a younger female. Just checking the barricades and everything, making sure everything's tight. Pulling on the bars against the windows, the wooden planks against the windows, to make sure they're still sturdy. Is Irina
Koyana.
This is pretty cute. Yeah, okay. I'm sorry, Ben.
Right.
Cuter than a brother.
There you go.
Also more badass than a brother, so...
6 feet. Rena is a striking young woman with auburn hair. You see her kind of walking towards you, and she goes up to hug her brother. Brother, thank you. It's not thank you, but it's good to see you. You seem a little
drunk.
He kind of laughs, shrugging off, points to you guys. Yeah, I ran into some help. We're at the.
Whoa! We
did not purchase the wine.
We are hired. Adventurers?
Oh, we're helping.
We're helping, but
we're
not
right. We're helping, but don't refer to us as help.
We're better than that. I'm Jenny. This is Bob.
Yeah.
I'm Shannon.
Oh,
this is our dog, Muffin.
Muffin.
You see, I kind of adjust her collar a little bit to hide any marks she might have. Yes, it's nice to meet you. Oh, are you here to help us?
Yes.
Yep.
My brother is quite the warrior, but Valaki is a safer place for me and him, honestly.
Yep.
And possibly for you all as well.
We are here to help take you there.
But she kind of like looks around, and she looks at like Brar. She looks down at Mankel. And she's like... Jim. I don't know how they'll receive the little green one.
Well, he is part of our team. He's indispensable.
He's wearing a cute sailor outfit.
No, he's not. That got changed out.
we ripped the sleeves off, but the rest of it's still there.
I mean, cute.
True.
He's still got like the tap shoes on.
Seen better days.
Oh god, it's filthy. It's
this
horrible. But once there was this
adorable.
Cute sailor suit.
Yeah.
Once upon a time, it was an adorable sailor suit. Everyone fawned over him.
For like an hour.
It was a time.
It was maybe.
Should I comb his hair?
About 15 to 20 minutes, maybe.
Yeah.
He's.
Do you think if we disguise
different.
Him in a cloak?
What if
looking.
You put him. Put a wig on?
The people around here are cautious of outsiders.
Some of them nearly lost their shit.
Let's just look back at Mankel. I want to make it real clear. You be proud of you,
mm-hmm.
right? That Mankel's said, wonderful. Can we? Does anyone have like a deep hooded cloak that you can wear?
I have an extra red brand cloak. Still, I still have my red brand.
Does it have a good hood?
Yeah.
So you can just...
I mean,
like,
he's
have
little. It's an adult-sized hood that we're putting it on child.
And
yeah.
You can call him a Christian.
It's this kind of reminds me of the episode... Well, not episode, but the movie E.T. where they're trying to dress the alien to make him look like going trick-or-treating as, like, a human kid.
Basically that, yeah.
Just waddling
exactly
around.
Basically exactly that. All right, so I'm
just,
like, giant
ogre
gloves. I'm going to put the red cloak on, but I'm going to take my dagger out. Because it's going to be too long for him, so I'm going to cut it to where it's just above his ankle, so he can still wrap it around himself.
Okay.
I think you don't need to cut it. I think it just needs to be long.
Just dragging, like,
he can be like a little Jawa.
Like 2 feet behind him.
We are not
boy.
Toting a Jawa.
Yeah, I think we
are.
Anyway.
Should I, like, run outside and change and hide in the door?
If you wanna.
I'm feeling kind of awkward now.
Yeah, just go like lean
creeper?
On somebody. Just go lean on one of them and be like, I need pets. That's what dogs do. I don't know. You do whatever you want to do.
You do.
I'm so sick looking for this girl and I can't do it. It's an elf.
Keep moving.
We will in a moment.
I suspect the girl will run across, like, if we're going to run across a trail, it's not going to be in this town.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is me being a little bit metagamey. I don't think you need to worry about being a dog this entire time.
Okay.
My
unless you
want
to
suggest
to go, like, share or somebody's
was bed. You learn the smell or whatever, so then if we ever run across it again.
Maybe I'll smell it.
Maybe you'll smell it.
Okay, well.
I don't know. I don't think you need to stay a dog for that purpose, if you don't want to be a dog.
Fine, Shanna.
Why are you following me?
I'm gonna change.
Did you say that?
Just to Shanna only.
You can't whisper. It's just a monotone.
Oh, that's fine. It is monotone. So you're just gonna...
like tag me and like
fine.
Look at it. Like, I think the dog needs to go to the bathroom. We'll be right back. And I'm gonna walk towards the door to take the dog out.
Okay, she follows you out.
Who follows me out?
Well, not out, but she follows you to the door,
okay.
Opens it, unlocks it for you, and then locks behind you guys as you go out.
So we're telling them that I was the dog?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know what the plan is for you guys.
No, we're not going to tell
I'm going to lie really hard. One way or another.
I don't think we need to lie.
Just the dog wanted to go on an adventure, and then you showed up. You were like...
why are we making a big deal out of it?
It's a big deal to me. I've been really awkward. I, like, nuzzled him.
Oh, we're just gonna tell him the truth. We're just
give him a big wink when you come back in.
Fair.
Okay. No, we're gonna put some makeup on you before you come back in. We're gonna pinch your cheeks.
I mean, fair is fair if he gets to nuzzle your back, right? Is that how it works? I don't know.
I wouldn't mind that.
Oh my god. We need to leave quickly at the end of this game, guys.
Alright, so you bring me back in.
Uh huh. Like, hey guys, where's the back?
Okay.
Both the sister and brother are kind of like, what?
Well, truth be told, Morning Thunder here is a druid, and she has the ability to turn into animals.
Right.
She's one with nature.
Just in case.
She's one with nature.
Not a werewolf. But just regular elf.
She usually likes to turn into a big fat bear.
I love being fat bear.
Can we be upfront, honest with each other from here on out?
Sure. I didn't mean to be deceptive.
She
just met you when I was a dog, and it's kind of awkward for me.
It's very weird for her to transform in front of other people.
She's
how would you feel?
I have anger issues.
I have
daddy
issues.
I thought
we were
being
honest.
Yes, it's serious. We just stand in a circle and talk about our problems.
I have, like, general trust issues.
I just got really deep in this friendship, guys.
We didn't mean to deceive you. It's just we didn't really know how to. Once she had already become a dog, it was a little bit difficult to go from there.
And how would you feel if a dog transformed into a human in front of your eyes?
Elf.
Into an elf in front of your eyes.
It's really creepy, too, when she does it.
Yes.
Like,
it's really weird.
The elf just
like, well, the thing, no, she doesn't go all at once. I'm sorry.
It's like just your hind legs are like elf, and then everything else is still dog, and he's like,
oh my god. Kill me.
Sometimes the right arm lags behind, so it's still like a dog for a couple of hours.
Can you even imagine? That's horrifying. I'm sorry.
It is.
That's not canon. I'm sorry.
It is.
It's like all elf body and like a dog head. It's just like really confused look on its face. Just.
Oh, what do I do?
All right, guys. Bring it back.
What do I do? What do I do?
Bring it back in.
Listen, I'm sorry, okay? I just was really embarrassed. And then it just kept getting worse and worse, and I didn't know what to do.
Listen.
You have salt.
We understand. That's, what'd you just ask?
I said you have salt.
She really likes the way that you caressed her.
I was a little far. I think soft hands got the point across.
I mean, look at you, just a beautiful young moon elf.
We've been
okay.
On the road a long time.
Apparently.
The mist, it does weird things.
I blame the mist. I definitely blame the mist.
Yes, it's totally the mist.
It's all the mist.
It's all the
side effects.
We huffed a lot of the mist.
Would you like to roll a deception check?
It's not really
I don't
even
know what. I don't know what's not.
I don't know what the hell happened.
We're not
all
even thirsty. Some thirsty bitches.
I think we need to go back to the inn.
Okay, bring it
back.
They're
like, never mind. You know what? We're just going to
stride. Wow.
This place is so depressing. You gotta bring some comedy to it. I'm sorry.
You do. Oh,
otherwise, are they traveling comedy troupe from Van Dalen? It's like Brar's the center picture, and like Shanna's on the top left. I'm just like, and then it's like red on the other side going, and then just. Motho as human and Fatty Bear.
As half of
and
each
then of Mangle at the bottom. With Jim Jam. He's like this with Jim Jam.
Oh. Oh. Horrible.
That's okay.
Oh, Lord.
Well.
Arts project.
What happened?
So,
piece of soft leather, so I can just like roll.
We should get like actual portraits for you guys, though. That'd be cool.
Yeah, mine would look like a heart and a flower, because that's the only thing I know.
I want to draw a really awesome
lightning bolt.
And a lightning bolt.
Just.
Joey!
Bring it back.
Anyway.
Yes.
So the.
Dead father. Life. Yes.
Well, I think the graveyard thing, are they taking care of the grave digging part, and we just need to go like chuck the old man in there?
We can use
that's what I said.
Guards to watch our back as we dig.
So we didn't need to
do
digging.
Dig it?
That's
fine. If you guys don't want to, I'm not going
to
force you to.
I'm just trying to make sure, because I want to make sure that when we go tomorrow we go, because I don't want to get stuck out in the forest.
Can you?
I can
help me carry the body.
I can shovel good. Well, I probably not by myself. He's in a big box.
Yeah. Well,
Mangle can help. He's got his tongue.
It's actually,
he's actually stronger than you.
Yeah.
You're 20 now, or is it? Yeah.
I mean, we can go dig the grave right now, and then just have a very nice burial in the morning.
Mm. Okay, we can do that.
Okay.
That'd be good.
You can bring the sister with us, so you don't have some girl time, and you gentlemen go out. And, you know.
Are we carrying the body right now?
Do you
want to do the whole bury thing tonight, or do you want to wait till tomorrow?
We usually bury at dawn.
Okay, so we'll go and do the digging tonight, and then come back.
Prep. Okay,
cool.
Yeah.
Do you have any shovels? Do they have shovels?
The church should, yeah.
Okay. I don't have shovels.
And are we all going, or is it the guys are going and the girls are staying? Or are we just
it's up to you guys.
More people, faster digging.
Yeah, this way,
you keep watch.
In case townspeople are still looking for this dog wolf thing.
Yeah, they're seeing things like crazy.
It's like,
I'm imagining like Minkle and I and his mark digging, and then there's like three little mage hands just going.
They only last for one.
Well, the girls have to drink wine.
Yeah, we're just like drinking wine. It's like,
dig that. There we go.
Hey, Irina, let's just not have some wine. Just join us. Do
you want to ask? You do each other's hair? You know someone can touch this up?
We're going to get about 2 feet down and Michael's not going to be able to see the edge of it.
He's not going to see his own grave.
Alright, so let's all go help dig.
Yeah.
To the cemetery at dusk. Excellent idea.
It's early afternoon.
Okay, it's still 2 o'clock.
The sun does set earlier, being winterish, so it's
permanent overcast.
Yeah.
Whatever. As soon as it starts getting dark, we're out of there.
We're digging.
All right, so you guys leave the mansion, everybody, and that'll be a straight north shot, right-ish, the northwest-ish to the church itself.
We're definitely
going
to be walking back in the dark.
Leading up to it. Atop a slight rise against the roots of the pillar stone that supports Castle Ravenloft stands a gray, sagging edifice of stone and wood. This church has obviously weathered the assaults of evil for centuries on end and is worn. A bell tower rises toward the back, and flickering light shines through the holes in the shingled roof. The rafters strain feebly against their load. As you approach the doors, the heavy wooden doors of the church are covered with claw marks and scarred by fire.
Good Lord.
But I think that'll be a good stopping point
for
today. So next time we'll walk into the church and see what could possibly
just
happen.
Just say the dog's second thing.
Huzzah!
Alright, thanks guys for tuning in. This has been an entertaining episode. Say the least.
That we're going to be discussing
all the time,
Right?
Nope.
I mean, a little bit of alcohol goes a long way.
Yeah. This wasn't even our drunkest session. It was just
oh my god.
Our
was
ditchliest one.
This has been the most, what is the word that completely is escaping my brain right now for what all
penetration.
Of
Light-hearted?
It's been a very penetrating episode. Very penetrating.
Yes.
Suggestive.
Very thrusting.
Sorry if our humor was thrusted upon you.
We didn't mean to violate anyone.
Wow.
Thanks everyone for tuning in.
Thanks.
We'll see you guys. When is the next March? Is it next week? Or
they're,
the next
they're not coming back. Let's not.
Sure. Yeah. We'll see the new people next week. Next weekend, though, right?
It's next weekend and then the next weekend.
Yep. So we'll post up our calendars as well. But our next two sessions will be the next following 2 weekends.
Yeah.
So that'll be exciting. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Woo. Thank you.
Bye.